The Philippine Transportation Department vows to look for legal ways to fast-track the procurement process for drivers' license cards and license plates. The LTO, which is under the Transportation Department, had announced a looming shortage of license plates by June, while some of its offices have been printing drivers' licenses on paper. The LTO says the DOTR is the procuring entity and should be responsible for securing the supply. The DOTR, however, notes there was a delay on the LTO side on the procurement process, which should have been done in August of 2022. A Philippine court reopens a second drug case against detained former Senator Laila De Lima. Our correspondent Jeff Caparaz is now on the line for the details. Jeff, go ahead.
Yes, Ron, in an order dated April 24, 2023, Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court Branch 204, Judge Abraham Joseph Alcantara granted the prosecution's motion to reopen the trial to allow a public attorney's office lawyer to testify as a rebuttal witness. PAU lawyer Demetir Huerta personally arrived in court earlier. Also present at the trial is former Senator Laila De Lima and co-accused Ronnie Dayan. Huerta is PAU's OIC for Administrative Service and one of two PAU lawyers who assisted former Bureau of Corrections OIC Rafael Ragos in executing affidavits implicating De Lima in the illegal drug trade. Ragos would later on retract all his allegations against De Lima, claiming that the former Justice Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre had forced him to execute several affidavits. Aguirre denied the claim. De Lima's team had opposed the prosecution's move to reopen the trial, saying panel of prosecutors had already agreed to submit the case for decision and therefore waived the opportunity to present rebuttal evidence. But the Muntinlupa court said the decision to reopen the trial is discretionary on the part of the court. De Lima and Dayan are accused of receiving 10 million pesos worth of illegal of alleged drug money, which Ragos allegedly personally delivered to De Lima's house in Parañaque in 2012, supposedly to support De Lima's senatorial campaign. De Lima did not run for senator in 2013 elections, but in 2016. Both the prosecution and defense did not comment on Huerta's testimonies in court.
Yun lang at ang naging mensahe lang sa akin ni Senator Laila De Lima kanina, samahan po natin siya na magdasal at madesisyonan na itong kaso na to sa Mayo 12 at umaasa siya na na ang hukuman ay magdedesisyon nga base sa ebidensya at merito ng kaso.
The testimony of Demetir Huerta is to be presented in order to contradict or controvert the allegation of Ragos that the words contained in his two statements were supplied by Attorney Rigel Salvador, also of the Public Attorney's Office, and to prove that there was no coercion on the part of the Public Attorneys.
Ron, on May 8, the court will decide on the bail petition of De Lima's camp. They will also stick to the schedule for the promulgation of judgment, which is earlier set on May 12, 2023, where the court will announce its verdict on De Lima and co-accused Ronnie Dayan. Ron?
Jeff Caparaz with that story. Thanks, Jeff. As part of their long-term innovation plan, the Philippine Economic and Development Authority hosts an event showcasing Filipino-made products and services. We have on the line Jackie Pascual with that story. Jack?
Hi, Ron. Filipinovation. This is a term widely used today at the 2023 National Innovation Day at the Philippine International Convention Center in Pasay. As the term suggests, it's all about Filipino and innovation. The National Economic and Development Authority, who organizes the event, believes that innovation is needed for the country to improve economically. Students and entrepreneurs are being taught here how to make their innovative ideas into a reality, with several mentors from different industries and other experts helping them make that dream come true. An exhibit was also set up here showcasing the different Filipino-made products or services that are helping or will help the public. Among them, Ron, are GPay. It's an app with an automated fare collection system for jeepneys and tricycles. There's also Microscope, a Pinoy keychain microscope. And there's also Jericord, a three-string instrument to help young kids learn how to play a guitar. Yusek Edilion or Rosemary Edilion said that the government will help innovators to help improve their products or ideas. And he said that there may be government may provide funding and provide education and training to the young innovators. So for now, Ron, the event has just the formal event or the speeches. NEDA Secretary R.C. Balisacan was just here, and other top officials and diplomats from different countries. And later, there will be other events lined up, like a exhibit and a dinner with other entrepreneurs here at the PICC. And that's the latest, Ron. Back to you.
Jackie Pascual, thanks.